Welcome to Wildcat TV.
Happy Thursday, Wildcats, and welcome back to another episode of Wildcat TV on youtube.com/WildcatTV. I'm Mariah Lawrence.
And I'm Sky Sherwood, and we're almost done with our first week of the stay-at-home series.
I know, time flies when you're bored out of your mind and you've got nothing to do.
Actually, no, it doesn't. Like, not at all.
Yeah. Okay, well, Kogan might have some ideas of how to keep us occupied.
Hey, Wildcats. I know you guys have all been bored and not knowing what to do during this quarantine, so I'm here to show you some ways to stay active and some activities to do around the house to pass the time. The first activity you can do is go on a bike or a walk or a run at a local park. Here, me and Tim went on a bike at the Little Blue Park. You can also go on a walk around your neighborhood, and if you have a dog, take them with. My family went on a walk around our neighborhood and took our three dogs, Betsy, Phoebe, and our brand new puppy, Theo. There has also been a lot of online fitness challenges that have been posted on social media. Our own volleyball team has been posting a lot of those, so go ahead and check those out and don't be afraid to participate in them. And the last activity is the one that I had the most fun with, and that was doing a bunch of trick shots with a cup and a ping pong ball around my house. But first, please enjoy this compilation of me missing those trick shots and screaming very loud about it.
Oh! Come on!
I hope I gave you some ideas on what to do while we're in this quarantine. Stay safe and healthy, and don't forget to wash your hands. Signing off for Wildcat TV, I'm Kogan Davis.
You want to know another way to stay active during isolation?
Play basketball!
Play Animal Crossing! Yeah, play basketball.
Due to the coronavirus, our girls' basketball team ended their season just 2 wins away from the state title. The girls had one of their best seasons in school history, coming off a huge win of undefeated Liberty. The decision was made 2 days after their win, and the girls found out that their season was canceled during practice. But that didn't stop them from wanting to finish.
We were like, well, what are we going to do now? You know, like, we were crying and stuff, and then we were like, well, we're not ready to go home. Because, you know, this could be the last time that we're in this gym. And I was like, you know, I'm playing basketball in this gym, you know, but it could be like the last time that we walk in here, period, you know. Just like, you know what, we're just gonna do some drills. So we did one of our drills, scramble, and we just had to, you know, end it off on a good note. You know, it was crazy, like, we did not want to leave at all. And then after that was done, we did our last final countdown, and then we left. And it was really hard. Because it was just like we were right there, you know. Last two games, just leaving on. We were just discussing about how we were gonna leave on Thursday, game on Friday. If we win, we play on Saturday. If we lose, then we come back on Friday, you know. And it was right there in our hands. Like, I felt like I could just grab it, like, touch, like, we were all excited. Like, everybody had that mindset, like, we're bringing this home. Like, we are gonna have 2020 state championship on that banner. That was everybody's mindset. Everybody was so ready because we were just playing such good basketball. We had such good chemistry. Like, we were ready. We were hyped up. There was no bad vibes at all. Like, you know, it was that one thing, the one thing that could have happened, which actually happened, that held us back. That was the only thing that held us back. But to this day, I will say that that was a minor step back for a major comeback for the rest of that team who was coming back. I promise you they have it. They have the potential to do it. Sadly, we didn't get to do it this year, and that's okay, but it's a minor setback for a major comeback.
Blue Springs defeated Lee Summit West 68-58 to win sectionals. The Titans beat the Wildcats twice during the regular season, but the girls secured a win. With the help of Jada Williams having a game high of 32 points, and Aaliyah Bell having 11 points and 14 rebounds, to secure a huge team victory.
My favorite postseason game would probably Lee Summit West, because we got beat by them twice in the regular season, and honestly, we didn't play that good against them the first two times we played them, but we pulled out and they weren't ready for it. And it hurts to not be able to play the last two games, but still making it that far is just awesome and amazing. And I haven't made it that far, but it was devastating at first, and I cried for a week and a half straight, but then I was tired of the tears and everything.
Though no fans were allowed at the game, that didn't stop the girls. Let's go take a look at the girls' big win, 51-41. Johnson was all-conference and all-district, and freshman Jada Williams was all-conference, all-district, and all-state. Let's go talk to her to see what it's like to receive all three honors as a freshman.
I'm honored and blessed to be able to accomplish the things I did my freshman year, but my team's way more important to me than the individual stuff.
Congrats, girls, on an outstanding regular season and an amazing playoff season. We can't wait to see what you guys accomplish next year at another run at the state title.
Thanks, Sydney. Hey, today's episode was a quick one, but stick around until tomorrow for some positive stories around our area and student videos.
Don't forget to get some exercise on these beautiful days we're having lately.
See you tomorrow, and remember, it's a great day to be a Wildcat.